Now from Angel Stadium in Anaheim. Today, the finale of this three-game weekend set. It's the Oakland Athletics and the Los Angeles Angels. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. So the Los Angeles Angels have taken the first two games of this series, and today they'll go for the sweep. They played well, Chris, and they're looking for more of the same in this one.
Yeah, they've been the side shaking hands on the field after each game so far. Played solid baseball to earn those wins, as you said, but every game offers up its own unique challenges. So we'll see what those are today, but there's always a little extra motivation when you have an opportunity to sweep a series.
All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. First pitch moments away. On the hill and coming off a great start, Patrick Sandoval. How about a report on him, Chris?
Well, he's putting together a really nice season on the mound. ERA in the low threes. Very respectable when you consider guys are looking to do damage. They're not trying to just walk and hit singles. They're trying to hit homers and draw walks and score runs. So when you have a guy that can limit the other team from scoring more than a few runs, that's really tough to beat game in and game out.
And the pitch. Elvis Andrus takes a strike there as he stands at the plate now.
First pitch, 107.
The 0-1.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole, he's going to have to battle, hope he gets a mistake. One guy that was really great once the count got to two strikes, Miguel Cabrera.
And a foul ball, he stays alive. On the ground and foul ball. Ground ball left side. Rendon throw to first. One up, one down.
Batting second, the center fielder, Christian Pache.
Here's Christian Pache. First pitch just misses.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. And boy, umpire didn't give him the call. I bet you if he throws it again, hitter knows he's going to have to swing it.
The pitch. That one ran inside, almost got him. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And now two gone. Here's Tony Kemp.
The second baseman, Tony Kemp.
To the right side. That's a base hit.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Just one of those seen high base hits through the infield. He just kind of rolled over on it a little bit, but sometimes those can find a hole and get you a knock.
Here's Sean Murphy. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Kemp off of first with two away. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger. And perhaps the best pitch he'll see in this at-bat to hit.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. And that is that. The A's strand one. A's zero. Angels coming up. Back after this on the show. We go to the bottom of the first. Here's David Fletcher. He has consistently been one of the best in the sport against lefties, and yet the righties give him trouble. You know, you don't want to be labeled as that guy, but the numbers say what they say.
Well, he's a good player, but if he wants to be great, he's going to have to figure it out against right-handed pitchers. There's so many right-handers in the game that you're going to see them one after another. So you would imagine with that many looks, Boog, that the adjustment's got to be coming soon.
And one and two. Next pitch in the dirt. 2-2. That hits the dirt and a full count now. This one in the air right field. Piscotty moving under this one. He's got it. And there's one away.
Batting second, the first baseman, Matt Duffy.
Matt Duffy digs in now. Sat out last night's game, but back in there today. And first offering is fouled off. Next pitch is downstairs.
One ball, one strike.
Next one is off the play. And a count 2-1. Two-one pitch is in there, and the count is even. And down on strikes. And here this afternoon, two quickly away in the bottom of the first. Here's Mike Trout.
The center fielder, Mike Trout.
First pitch, not close. Ripped on the ground a second to first. That is the inning. And the Angels are gone in order. We played an inning. No score. Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Sheldon Noisy. Having a lot more success on the road this season.
Noisy.
Sandoval back to work. And that one lifted in the air center field. Trout makes the grab. One pitch and one out.
Woo, he was all over that first pitch fastball. Just barely missed it. Man, this guy was ready to hit.
Here's Stephen Piscotty. In there, and it's 0-1. Next offering is in for a strike.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
Stays alive. No score here in the second. And a foul ball. He stays alive. The next offering misses. Ball one.
One ball, two strikes. Down.
And a pitch. That one the other way, and that's just foul. Good battle here. About to be the eighth pitch of the at-bat. Swing and a bouncer. Fletcher gloves it. Now the throw to first on the run. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
Batting seven, the left fielder, number 22, Stephen Vogt.
Here's Stephen Vogt. Liner, base hit.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. Everything was on time and fluid in that swing. Got a pitch he could get the barrel on and lined it into center for the knock. Those always feel good.
Next up for the A's, Jonah Bride.
Kind of a throwback. No batting gloves.
In there for strike one. And a pitch. Ball one there.
I got a ball, one strike.
So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Second inning here, no score. Next offering way off the plate. Swing and a miss, and that is that.
I think the key is arm action on the changeup. When you can sell it like a fastball, you drop the velocity, you get the swing and miss, and you walk off the field.
And welcome back. Now here is Shohei Ohtani.
And leading off for the Angels, the designated hitter, Shohei Ohtani.
The pitch. There's a strike.
That fastball at the bottom of the zone can be very effective. Just got to keep it on the corners.
Now 1-1. Gary Simmons has the plate duty in this one.
Well, with Simmons, it's not always your standard strike zone, Boog. It kind of gives a little extra in some parts of the zone and then can be tighter in others. But I think the important thing is he doesn't get labeled as inconsistent. So you got to stay ready up there.
Strike two. Yeah, one of those umpires, you just have to know what to expect, right?
Exactly.
The next pitch misses. Full count now.
He really committed to that fastball up at the top of the zone. He knows that if he makes a mistake in the zone, it gets hit hard by a power guy like this. That's a nice miss right there.
The 3-2 is off the outside edge, and that is ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Now it's Anthony Rendon. Next pitch has popped up. Bright makes the grab, and there's one down.
That was a good hard fastball with some nice ride up in the zone right there. Hitter looked like he was on it, but I think that velocity at the end just beat him. Instead of a line drive or something hit deep, it's a pop up and an easy out for the defense.
Swung on, belted. That ball's carrying. Gone! Jaren Walsh blasts one out. Home run number 20 on the year, and that gives him a lead. It's 2-0.
With a low 90s fastball, you have to live on the edges and hit your spots. If you don't, you'll get hit hard. Really good swing there. Patient, waited for it. It was like BP all over again.
Justin Upton at the plate.
Batting seven. The left fielder. Justin.
First offering misses the mark.
Upton.
Still only one out here in the inning. Next one misses. Two balls, no strikes.
Well, he gave up the home run earlier in this inning, not pitching as aggressively here.
Next pitch, not close, up high.
Well, I would expect in this 3-0 count, you're taking all the way. See if they'll walk you.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Swings and misses at one down below the zone.
Good late sink on that fastball. Out of the hand, looks so good. And then by the time he gets in the hitting zone, hard to get the barrel to it.
Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Max Stassi comes up to hit. And he swings and misses, and it's nothing at one. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
Cut on and miss, struck him out, and two away now.
Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all batting strikes. Up. He wasn't not even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter, other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
Man at first. Now batting Tyler Wade. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Left-hand hitter waits. And a foul ball. The 1-1. Upton off of first with two away. In the air, center field. Pache racing over to make the catch. Two-run shot for the Angels this inning. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Top half of the third inning. Here's Oakland's DH, Jeremy Ironman.
Leading off for the Athletics, the designated hitter, Jeremy
Sandoval, back Ironman. To work. And first offering is fouled off. The wind of the pitch. That one misses. And a count even 1-1.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
Stays alive. And a pitch. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. One away. So the batting order turns over. And now the shortstop, Elvis Andrus, grounded out his first time. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Zips it across. First two batters retired here in the top of the third.
Up next to Oakland. The center fielder, Christian Pache.
Here's a speed threat, Christian Pache.
Well, they've kept him pretty quiet in this series. Still doesn't have a knock. I know you want to get that first knock out of the way. Maybe more will come, but you got to give some credit to the pitching staff. They've had a great plan against him.
First pitch, and he just misses. And it's even up.
One and one.
Kicks and deals. So now 1-2.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
The wind and the pitch. Oh, this is deep to left center. Way back there. On its way. Gone. That was a moonshot. And they cut into the lead. It's 2-1.
Just an excellent swing all the way around, and it had that sound coming off the bat that gets everyone's attention. Got a pitch to drive, short to the baseball, squared it up, and the backspin carried it out of here.
So two away with nobody on. Here's the second baseman, Tony Kemp.
The batter number five.
And there's a fly ball deep right field.
Kemp.
And out of here. That one barely got out of here. Home run number 10 of the year. And it ties it up. It's 2-2.
Back-to-back jacks, and this club is fired up right now, Boog. I mean, this is the kind of thing where you really start to notice hitters in a lineup feeding off each other, and the collective confidence just continues to grow.
So here's Murphy now.
Now batting, the catcher, Sean.
And first offering is
Murphy.
Fouled off. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. And it gets by him.
The third baseman, number 8, Sheldon.
Down the third baseman, Sheldon Noisy. Next pitch downstairs. And that is ball one. Next offering is in for a strike. Popped up. Puts the squeeze on that one. And that is that. But the long ball was working in this inning. Not once, but twice. 2-2 game. Welcome back as we go to the last of the third. Now it's the Angels leadoff man, David Fletcher.
David Fletcher.
The right-hander back to work. That misses the zone. Ball one.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field.
Well, the last 10 games or so have been anything but fun at the plate for him. So that one has to feel good. That's a good sound coming off the bat, man. And as he connected out front and lifted into the outfield, that's one of those swings where you just don't even feel the ball hit the barrel. That's a pure stroke.
And now it's Matt Duffy. Line drive, and it goes just foul. Tied up here in the early going. Murphy tries to block it, but it gets away. At the belt and fires. On the ground, right side. And he takes it himself for the out.
The center fielder, number 27. Mike Trout.
And now batting, Mike Trout.
He's been such a good hitter with runners in scoring position. Some guys just take it to another level. For him right now at the plate, it's like everyone else is in slow motion and he's in full speed.
Next offering is down low, and that's ball one. Bam. Next offering is in for a strike. Fletcher stands at third with one gone in the inning. Next pitch misses, and it's 2-1. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2.
Well, and those hitters count sometimes can be a little too aggressive, and a good pitcher will play off of that. He's got to get a better pitch to hit.
And here it comes. And now it's filled up. One away with a runner at third. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. And that's going to kick into the corner. In comes the run from third. It's 3-2. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Here's Shohei Ohtani.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Shohei.
Swings through that one, 0-1. Runner leads away at second. One out and a runner at second. Next offering is downstairs.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch, keep the bat alive.
Next offering misses, and that's ball three.
Well, he's not afraid to fall into a two-strike count. Knows the strike zone very well, so much so that I think umpires will look at him and determine whether it's a ball or strike, if he swings or not.
And that's ball four. Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate. This splits between April and May there. Next pitch is popped up, and the infield fly rule called.
Up next for the Angels, the right fielder,
Jared Walsh, the next to hit for the Angels. Right now the leading RBI man in the American League. He's been huge this season. And that's in there for strike one.
When you're struggling out there on the mound, hitters know that there'll be plenty of opportunities within the at-bat to try to get something to hit hard.
And the right-hander deals towards first, and it finds its way through for a hit. The run comes in from second, and they lead by two. And that'll put runners at the corners with two away.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one, ripped it down the line. Nice job of standing his mechanics.
Now, here is Justin Upton. Good power, not great in the OBP department. They say it went.
Up there.
Righty to the plate. Pitch misses. 1-1. Action in the pen down there. Number 36 appears to be getting loose. Number 74 getting cranked up as well. Here's a 1-1. Here's Upton. Swing and a drive. That one lifted deep to left. And it's gone. A three-run rocket. And they throw three on the board. It's 7-2.
That's exactly the pitch he was looking for, crushes it, and hits it out of the ballpark.
Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. James Caprillion, done for the day, and as he heads off, we'll step aside for a minute. Back with the new pitcher after this break. Number 36 takes over on the mound. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty.
Adam Oler.
Two outs, nobody on. And here's the catcher, Max Stassi.
The catcher, number 33, Max Stassi.
That one blasted deep to right. Back there. Bangs off the wall. And he'll pull into second safely. And next for the Angels, Tyler Wade.
Now batting, shortstop, Tyler Wade.
Ground ball up the middle. Throws to first. Inning over. Angels add three on this blast. It's 7-2. Back here at Angel Stadium, out of the fourth, and now the right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
The right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
Hawaii to kick the pitch. Fastball almost got him there. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock.
Oh, I'm sure he feels really good about that one. When you can turn a ball around at 107 off the bat, it's going to make you feel really good inside. If he elevates that a little bit more, it's definitely out of here.
So, man aboard, digging in for Oakland, Stephen Vogt. On the ground, a second, might be two. Good feed, that's one. How about that double play?
Now batting.
Really nice double play turn right there, and it all started with that sweet glove flip on the feed to second. You know, these middle infielders, they spend a lot of time honing that glove work, so it just becomes like second nature. I think you also have to have a really good glove that's broken in, that's not too large, so that you can have a feel for that baseball and be able to flip it like you're barehanded.
And now, Jonah Bride. That one hammered center field. That's back there. Turning, looking, and that one is gone. He circles the bases, and they slice into the lead. It's 7-3.
Love to see a hitter aggressive on the first pitch of an at-bat. You watch him from the on-deck circle, so when you step in the box, you're ready to pull the trigger wherever it's at. Really good job by the hitter. Total conviction on that swing.
Jeremy Ironman up next for the A's.
Now batting, designated hitter, Jeremy.
That one's in there, 0-1.
Well, no base hits in the series for him so far, and it's clearly been a rough one. You just hope he's not pressing too hard, because that just compounds things. It makes the slump even longer. Never seems to help. Never helped me.
On the ground at first, Duffy collects. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Oakland gets one on this homer. It's now a four-run lead at 7-3. Back here at the ballpark, ready to go, bottom four. So in now for the Angels, David Fletcher.
The second baseman, David Fletcher.
And he deals. This to third, Noisy collects it. Whips it across, Fletcher retired.
The first baseman, number 5, Matt Duffy.
So digging in, Matt Duffy. First offering, and it just misses. The next offering misses, and the count is 2-0. Next offering is down low. Line drive, base hit.
The center fielder, number 27,
Mike.
Here's Trout.
Trout.
Next pitch downstairs, and it's 1-0. Duffy at first, one gone. Now this is in the air down the line. Cole makes the catch. Two down.
Now batting, the designated hitter, Shohei Ohtani.
Shohei Ohtani up to the dish. And the first offering is not close. Next pitch is outside. Left-hand batter waits. And that one wrapped foul. Here's a 2-2. Ground ball to the right side. They take the force out. And that is the third out of the inning. Angels lead one, but they lead it by 4. It's 7-3. Ready now for the fifth inning. Leading off, Elvis Andrus.
Leading off for the Athletics, the shortstop, Elvis Andrus.
Here comes a pitch. And he takes a strike. And that gets the top of the zone for a strike. And down on strikes he goes. One down.
Well, that at bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the now plate right there. At least to foul something off, extend that at bat.
Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Christian Pache. He's already homered here in this one. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike. The wind of the pitch. And a swing and a miss.
Man, he was really tardy on that fastball. Great job of setting him up by throwing the curveball. Add some velocity to it on the next pitch. Can't catch up.
Next pitch is downstairs.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
Smash to the left side. And the first two set down to the top of the fifth.
Fastball grooved right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air, maybe drive it into the gap.
Two outs, bases empty. Now it's the second baseman, Tony Kemp. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next one misses, and it's 2-0.
2-0 count to a guy like this at the plate. You've got to throw a pitcher's pitch. Don't just try to get a strike. He could make you pay.
That hits the dirt, and it's 3-0.
A rare three-ball count here. He's been throwing strikes all day. Got to be ready to hit if you're in the box.
Two down, nobody on.
Hey. Three balls, one strike.
3-2 now. Swings and misses. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Nothing doing there for the A's. Deficit remains at 4. It's 7-3. Back in Anaheim, John Schaube with my buddy Chris Singleton. It's set to get us started. Bottom 5, Anthony Rendon.
Third baseman, Anthony Rendon.
The pitch swings here and blasts one left field way back out of here. He'll touch them all. His 14th of the year. It's 8-3.
That one was a hanger, and pitchers typically don't get away with making a mistake like that. And right there, he made him pay.
Jared Walsh, the next to hit for the Angels.
Now batting, the right fielder, Jared Walsh.
And that one fouled off. Kicks and fires.
That's a ball.
That one inside. Two balls and a strike. And a 2-1 on the way. That one out to right. Piscotty settles underneath it. And out number one on the grab.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Fielder number 10, Justin
And here is Justin Upton. He's already homered in this game. And first offering is fouled off.
He's getting the barrel to the ball. He's just got to work on that timing a little bit.
Right-handed reliever. And that one a little bit high. Righty delivers. Check swing, no appeal. And the count is 3-1. The 3-1. Swings through that one out in front that time. Popped up. And puts the squeeze on it. That's out number two.
Now batting, catcher, Max Stassi.
And now the catcher comes up to here. Max Stassi. Ripped back to the mound, and that got him. Right, takes it himself, and that is the inning. Anthony Rendon going deep for the Halos. It's now 8-3. New inning getting started. Here's the Oakland cleanup hitter, Sean Murphy.
Leading off for the Athletics, the catcher, Sean Murphy.
The pitch. There's the strike.
That fastball, even though it's up, that's the velocity you want to go after. Low 90s, a lot better than trying to hit the high 90s.
Next offering is in for a strike. And the pitch. The punch out there. Now one away. Next up for the A's, Sheldon Noisy.
Third baseman, Sheldon Noisy.
Liner to second and picked on the hop. Fletcher fires over to first. Two quick outs to open the top of the sixth.
Now batting, the right fielder, Steven.
Digging in for Oakland, Stephen Piscotty, 1-2. In there for strike one. This one high in the air to left center. Trout, long run into the gap. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. It's the Angels 8 and the A's 3. Welcome back. There we go, bottom six. Now it's the shortstop, Tyler Wade.
And leading up for the Angels, the shortstop, Tyler Wade.
And a pitch. High fly ball out of the left center field. Puts it away for the out.
Now batting, second baseman, David Fletcher.
Back to the top of the Angels lineup, David Fletcher, the next to hit for the Angels. First offering misses badly for ball one. One down, base is empty. Good eye right there. That one gets down for a hit.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. When you pop a ball up like that, you don't expect it to get you a knock too often, but right there, somehow he got it to drop in behind first base, and that's where no one could get to it.
And now Matt Duffy, first pitch, not close. In the air, right side of the infield. That's a hit. Into third now. So runners at the corners and one out.
Up next for the Angels, the center fielder, Mike Trout.
So one out with two aboard. Now Trout gets a chance to hit. Ground ball left side, could be two. To second, there's one, double play. And that'll do it for the inning. We're through six full. It's the Angels 8 and the A's 3. Top of inning number 7. And the batter now, Stephen Vogt.
Leading off for Oakland, the left fielder, number 22. Stephen Vogt.
The pitch. Ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit.
Right there does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
The first baseman, Jonah Bride.
Man at first, Jonah Bride. Up next for the A's. In there, and it's 0-1.
If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
Next offering is in for a strike. Vote on at first, nobody out. Lifted in the air, right center field. Trout glides to his left, pulls it in on the run, and there's one down.
Up next for Oakland, the designated hitter.
Here's Oakland's DH, Jeremy Ironman. And that's in there for strike one. 0-2 as he waves at that one. The pitch. And that's outside.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
Ripped, but it curls foul. And now the lefty, and a foul ball, he stays alive. And a pitch. That one misses. Two balls, two strikes. Not even close there. And it's 3-2. Fouled off, he was late. And a pitch. And that's ripped into left. Base hit. They fired in quickly. So it's first and second with only one away.
Man, that was a pretty good battle at the plate. And I'll tell you, it feels pretty good as a hitter when you grind out a hit like that. Solid swing from start to end. On time with everything. Really good balance. Nice extension. And he met it out front for the line drive knock.
So the lineup flips over. Here's Elvis Andrus. Here comes the manager out of the dugout, and he'll make a move for the bullpen. Patrick Sandoval gives way, and the line not closed on him yet as he's responsible for the runners on base. Back with a new pitcher after this. New pitcher in the game for the Angels, Griffin Canning. Hasn't pitched in a while. He's had the last 5 days off.
I'm just keeping it real. Everybody knows how I feel. Cause you wasn't there when I almost drowned in my own blood, sweat, and LLV. I remember him and Jag used to control the
parties. Ground ball left side, could be two. Just got him on that one.
Now batting, the center fielder, Christian Pache.
Next to hit, Christian Pache, 1-for-3.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here. Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation. You know, maybe a long relief guy to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Bounce to third. Rendon picks it up, slings it across. That's out number three. Eight strand a couple. Can't chip away at an 8-3 deficit. Back here at Angel Stadium, now it's the power speed combo, Shohei Ohtani.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
Yeah, the right-hander back to work. Misses inside, 1-0. Oakland's bullpen has some movement. Deolis Guerra getting loose out there. Pruitt getting loose as well. The 1-0. That misses, 2-0.
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound, okay with getting deep in the count, even falling behind. Well, in this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
Left-hand hitter waits. And that one sliced foul. The pitch. Swing and blast one down the line. It's gone if it's fair, but it hooks foul.
Oh, it's a really good pass of the ball right there. Just a little bit too quick. He's got to find a way. Just let it travel a hair more.
And he walked him.
And leading up,
Anthony Rendon making his way to the plate.
Anthony Rendon.
Good speed on the base pass. He handles the bat very well. I wouldn't be surprised if the skipper puts on some type of hit and run or a run and hit.
Next one is off the play. Ball two. Swing, and that's ripped towards right center. Dives, and he can't hang on. Oh, he throws it away.
Just so sound in his mechanics. Hits against a firm front side, and the hands just continue to carry through the middle of the field.
And next for L.A., Jared Walsh. First offering misses the mark. at the belt and fires. Swing and a tapper that rolls foul. Otani, the lead runner at second. Rendon on at first with nobody out. Next pitch is outside.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Next offering is downstairs. And the right-hander deals. And there's ball four.
You get a walk. And you get a walk. Everyone gets a walk, boo.
The left fielder.
So up next, Justin Upton.
Upton.
First pitch just misses.
Well, this is a tough situation with the bases loaded, but the healthiest mindset is just try to get outs one hitter at a time.
And there's a strike.
One ball, one strike.
Bases juiced, no outs. And a count one and two. The next pitch misses, and the count is two and two.
This is a situation where the hitter is looking for something up in the zone that he can get his arms extended. What you have to be careful of is that pitch that's up, that's in on your hands. That'll pop you up in the infield, and that's exactly what the pitcher wants.
Next offering misses, and now it's three and two.
Two walks in the inning already, and he just doesn't seem comfortable out there, like he can find the right mechanics and then repeat them.
And that one fouled off. All loaded up, dangerous hitter at the plate. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Great effort as he's able to haul it in. Both runners tagging from second and third. Safe! And they add to their lead as the run scores from third.
Well, right there, he's definitely looking for more than just a sack fly with the bases loaded and nobody out, but you'll take it. Now it's up to the guys coming up behind him to pick up the rest of those runners on base.
So a new pitcher on the mound for the A's, Jorge Juan. He comes in with his team trailing by a bunch, so he'll try to keep it where it is.
Juan.
Here's the catcher, Max Stassi. First pitch, and he just misses. Next offering is in for a strike. The other way, and foul ball. And the righty deals. And there's a ball. Kicks and deals. And now it's filled up. Now move to first. Walsh back on a dive. Payoff pitch. This one popped up. Foul ground first base side. Murphy makes the grab. That's out number two.
Good hard fastball up in the zone right there. They look really good coming in, but so hard to get on top of as a hitter.
Here's the shortstop at the plate, Tyler Wade. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Next offering is down low. Now 3-0. Runners on first and third, two away. The right-hander gives up the two-out walk.
Well, interesting. He went with the off-speed and walked the hitter. Man, you got to challenge the guy with the fastball.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now it's the Angels' leadoff man, David Fletcher. Right side. And that one tracked down by Piscotty out in right field. Fletcher retired. And that will end the inning. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Angels 9 and the A's 3. And welcome back. Here's the second baseman, Tony Kemp.
Leading off for the Athletics, the second baseman, Tony Kemp.
Cannon back to work. That's in for a strike. That's out to center field. Trout is there. And a quick out number 1.
The batter, the catcher, Sean Murphy.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Sean Murphy. That one's in there, 0-1. And a pop-up, right side, foul territory. And gobbled up by Duffy, and there's 2 down.
Man, he just couldn't lay off right there. Those high fastballs, they just look really good because they're eye level, but they're just about impossible to get the barrel to.
Sheldon Noisy, up next for the A's. High in the air, out to right. Walsh on his way over, and that's the third out. And the A's are gone in order. Still way back, it's 9-3. Back here at the ballpark, out of the bottom of the eighth, Matt Duffy to lead it off.
And leading off for the Angels, the first baseman, Matt Duffy.
And here it comes. Ball 1, no strikes. Next offering is in for a strike.
Well, it looks like he's wanting to work the upper part of the strike zone. What does that mean? Top hand better be working for the hitters. Adjust that side a little bit. Give yourself a chance to hit.
Next pitch is downstairs. That one in for a strike, 2-2. Foul ball. A wind of the pitch. That one the other way. One gone to the bottom of the eighth.
The center fielder, number 27, Mike Trout.
Mike Trout now at the plate. That's ripped. Base hit. That ball was absolutely ripped. 111 off the bat. And I'm pretty sure it started to whistle after it left the bat.
I think I heard that too, Boog. And these are the moments we appreciate when we can look at StatCast and just see exactly what the data is. Always so much fun to see what numbers pop up.
Trout on the move. Pitch outside. The tag, and he's out at second.
That goes to show you stealing a base is a tough thing to do and far from a sure thing, even with big-time speed. It's not easy to catch him, but that was a great catch and throw. Quick, not rushed, and accurate.
And there's a foul ball. The wind of the pitch. In there. And so now 1-2.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Next offering is downstairs.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
On the ground to the left. Tosses to first. Gets him easily, ends the inning. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Jansen Junk. He has a great slider with tons of movement. We go to the ninth. Now it's the right fielder, Stephen Piscotty.
Leading off for the Athletics, the right fielder.
The pitch.
Stephen Piscotty.
Ball one, no strikes.
I can't play around with him here. It's a six-run lead at this point. Got to attack hitters, even if you give up a solo shot.
The next offering misses. Two balls, no strikes to count. Swing and a miss. And a count, 2-1. That one misses in the dirt.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
In for a strike. Now it's 3-2. A wide to kick the pitch. Bounding ball here. Rolls foul. Here comes a pitch. Right through there. Got him. And they get the leadoff man in the ninth.
Frustrating end to the at-bat for the hitter, and I'm sure that's going to sit on him for a little while. You want to be ready to hit the fastball. Sometimes you can overthink things, and I think that was the case right there.
Striding to the plate now for Oakland, Stephen Vogt. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Puts it away for the out.
The batter, the first baseman, Jonah Bride.
And here's the first baseman, Jonah Bride.
And there's one thing on the minds of these fans, and that's the sweep.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike. And a foul ball.
Well, the hitter's got his timing down for the breaking ball. If you're a pitcher, if you can get that fastball in on the hand, it's going to be very difficult for that hitter to get the barrel to it.
He's got it. Ball game. And the Angels come in here and finish off a three-game sweep.
Well, with the sixth win in a row, all of a sudden, you start to look around, up and down the lineup, to your left, to your right as a player, and you say, you know what, we're good. We may have had some tough times earlier on, but this is a good team, and you start to expect this kind of play out of yourselves. We'll see if this translates into a longer winning streak than it is right now.
9-3, your final here in this one. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
for this afternoon. First for the victorious Angels, 9 runs, 12 hits. No errors, they left 8 men on base. For the Athletics, 3 runs on 9 hits. No errors, they left 5 men on base. Time of the ballgame, 3 hours and 31 minutes. Thank you for joining.